6.5 million couples plan to get engaged on Valentine's Day. And even if you're not getting engaged, the holiday can still be pricey. Last year's numbers from American Express show typical spending for gifts, cards, candy, and dinner were about $214 a couple. Overall, Americans spend about $37 billion on this holiday. So if you're going to spend the money, how about gifts that might last more than a week? Eight on Your Side has some answers to thinking like that. Joining me now is John Wax from Waller & Wax Advisors and Raymond James. And I like this idea. Give a gift that lasts longer than a week.
Yeah, I mean, really, why give something that dies in a week? What does that really say?
It doesn't say enough, because I'm not a fan of flowers for that very reason.
No,
and candy is not a good alternative, because that's gone like that, too.
Faster than the flowers.
Exactly. Yeah. So what are some ideas that could still be romantic?
Well, I mean, obviously, you have the things like jewelry and clothes, but, you know, you could also think about bigger type of things, like maybe a trip somewhere, something that you can afford, but also something that has like a lasting memory.
Right, so think more of experience or memory instead of dollar signs.
Sure.
That goes back to when we were talking about when you look at last year's budget, what'd you spend money on that you really liked?
Exactly.
And that's where you should spend money.
Exactly.
Okay, I know stocks probably aren't romantic, but are there some stocks you could buy your loved one?
Naturally, I'm gonna default that direction, because in a way, you're buying something that has a much better chance of not whittling and dying in 7 days than buying
flowers.
Especially
if it offers a dividend, right?
Especially a dividend, exactly. Exactly.
How would your wife feel about getting stocks from you?
Well, she has, and she probably will continue to get them, but I expect there'll be flowers as well as part of the whole deal.
All right, so what else is another idea? What else keeps giving?
Well, I mean, really, I'm going to default back to something that has a rising value. I know it doesn't sound so romantic, but when you talk about doing something with like a share of a stock or a share of a mutual fund, you know, it does continue to grow, and it also could be a good way, as you're talking with your kids on this romantic holiday, is to kind of maybe instill some affection or love towards seeing wealth grow.
I like that. I mean, teaching your loved ones about the value of that.
Exactly.
Okay, good advice.
Sure.
Beats candy and flowers any day.
I think so.
All right, you could still do a little candy and flowers.
Yes.
And some stock.
In budget.
Yes. Thanks, John.